Okay. What last thing? What's the most common mistake you've seen people do on a heavy bag?
I think what I described earlier, that like
standing one place
for 9 minutes, for 12 minutes, you're just here. You know? And then you get in that ring and you're surprised why you get so exhausted having to move around, or why you walk into shots or whatever it is. You know, try your best to make it realistic. Now, that being said, you need some experience in order to actually practice stuff. So somebody walks into the gym for the first day, I can't expect them to do all these things on the bag. Even after I teach them the punches and things like that, I still can't expect them to put these situations together because they've never gone through the situations in the first place.
How high should be a heavy bag when you put it up? Should it be like human height? Should it be higher or lower?
It should be, you know, in the same vein of this whole video, it should be at a realistic height of what your opponent would be, you know.
And that's it. And now, this heavy bag is about 150, 180 pounds?
These are 200 pounders. These are 200
each
pounds.
One?
Yeah.
Well, I've seen there are all kinds of sizes of heavy bag. How do you choose the right one, Brandon?
Well, you see, I have a variety because each one is going to offer you a little bit different things
to practice.
The
first one, the water one, is uppercuts, right?
The water one's cool because you can have a lot of unique angles. So the big bag is cool, it's big, right? But it kind of makes you want to throw wide because
it's
so...
But you can't really dig
you
in.
You can't go short either, right? So on this one, I can throw a wide hook, right? From like the long range. But I can also throw a short hook on this one, right? On this one, I can throw a long right hand. But on this one, I can also throw a short right hand. And also, like you said, uppercuts, right? Which are a great benefit to this bag. This one...
Shaped like a skinny, anorexic human being.
This one has seen some rounds at my gym. For you guys that have been following Outlaws for a long time, you know that at one point this was a double end bag. And this bag is the shit, man.
You love it.
It's hard, it's dense, just like somebody. And now that thing broke off, we have it kind of free flowing. It gives you a lot of movement. You gotta work on timing, working into the shots. You get unique angles with it. Moving around, controlling it with that jab. Sometimes we work like an endurance drill where you occupy and you just kind of keep it up like this.
And then look at this, it got blown up. I've never seen such a big double end bag.
And what I like about this is you can put combos together because it's not gonna drop away from you. So that one, if I hit it, it will eventually drift away from me. This one, I can continuously put shots together.
Which reminds me,
it's gonna spring back.
I've been to LA Fitness a few times, and I've seen people hit the bag where it swings like crazy. I've never seen a pro have it swing like crazy. Why is that? Why is professional boxers, when they hit the bag, it barely even moves? Mayweather, or you don't see the bag really.
Again, because that what the LA Fitness guy is doing is not realistic and slack.
Do you want the bag to fly around like right now, or do you want it to stay? What's your goal when you hit it?
I want you to work the bag. I don't want the bag to work you. How about that?
So you don't want the bag moving. So how do you make sure you hit it hard without the bag flying all over the place? What's the key?
Or this, if it does fly all over the place, then you gotta work that into your technique. You have to be practicing. All right, your opponent does that sometimes. Sometimes your opponent's just there. And you gotta work those body shots and little moves, right? You gotta be able to work all different situations, Elie.
Brandon, many times we watch fighters and they gas themselves out. Like they would hit a bag for 30 seconds or a minute and they're done. Even in a pros in a ring, why is that? What's the key? Is the key stamina? Is they overdid it?
Yeah.
Too wide of a question?
Too wide of a question.
But how would you prevent that situation?
Through in-depth boxing training.
Just train.
I mean, the specifics, I can't give you the specifics right here. Every case is different. Everybody's, you know, what's making them fatigue, why it's going about, is not necessarily all the same. And you know what? Sometimes it has nothing to do with VO2 max or anaerobic threshold. It's there's sometimes deeper reasons.
You have
often.
By the way, you have another bag over here. One of your fighters is working on. It's shaped like a human being.
Yes.
Why is it hanging in the corner of the ring and not hanging up like the rest of them? What's the logic on that?
Well, this is Los Angeles, Elie, and real estate comes at a premium. So.
Oh, so if you had space, you put it up. Okay, yeah. No. That's I thought there was a reason. Do you like that bag?
I like it, yeah.
It's full of water, right?
It's good for a body. You see, from the shoulders down, it's very similar to a body. From the shoulders up, not so much, but yeah, it's filled with water. We already popped it twice.
Really? And what happens when you pop it?
This guy, I put an epoxy. Some
Any videotape of that? When someone pops it?
Nah, not yet.
Why did they pop it? They hit it too hard?
Yeah, it's just, look, anything in the boxing gym
will fall apart.
Like, its job is to get its ass kicked.
Like, how many times do you have to replace the most?
Maybe speed bags.
Speed bags, why?
Speed bags real quick, because people are idiots and they hit them too hard.
What do you mean hit them too hard? Aren't you supposed to hit your stuff hard? Like, I've seen them go hard.
Yes, people, I mean, they pound on my bag and then wonder why it pops, you know?
Like, they try to knock it out.
They try to knock it out. Exactly.
But it's cool. All right, so if you were going to start a home gym, which bag of all the bags over here would you personally pick to start with? What's the most you could get out of the bag?
If I'm going to put something up at my house?
Yes.
Double end bag, hands down.
Really?
Hands down.
Why?
Because you get to exude timing and distance. You have a target that... Here, let's go this one over here.
Do you have them loose or do you have them very tight?
Well, that one's very tight and this one is loose.
So you like the loose one?
Well, I'm going to demonstrate on this.
Okay, so you'd have to drill a hole in the floor, a hole in the ceiling.
Or you can even buy like a sandbag, a lot of them. Yeah, but you'll have to have something to attach it to the top.
Okay.
And then... again, just like I described the other bags, like, oh, I don't know what this is gonna do. I know, I'll use my jab. Oh, okay. Starting to understand what it does when I hit it. Starting to understand where it is, what it's timing. Boom, okay, eventually. Boom, boom, put some shots behind it, okay. Boom, boom, get back to that. Oh, shoot, it's out of control. I don't know what to do. I don't use my jab, regain control. Boom, put some shots, boom, make some counter punch, boom. Oh, boom.
Okay. There you have it, yeah, Brandon Krause. You knocked them out, you rattled them.
That's it.
And it doesn't hurt like the heavy bags, your hand. You can do it without gloves.
You can do it without gloves, yes. And I often have my fighters do it without gloves to be very precise with your knuckles.
You ever use like gardening gloves for stringing knuckles?
We do like a similar kind of idea. We use this a lot for that.
Okay.
So, an important aspect of boxing is that the final link of the chain, your fist.
The knuckles, yeah.
The knuckles, right? And hitting precise and having solid hands and having your hands conditioned. So we have this wall target. You can do a lot of different things on it, but one of the things that we really like to do here is with no gloves on, often with just hand wraps, but I don't need the hand wraps. I'll have my guy that'll come over. I go, all right, today we're going to start conditioning your hands. You're going to start working your punches here progressively harder and harder and harder until you're at the point where you can do rounds on this thing, full speed punches, and it doesn't matter. And I tell my fighters, okay, we're not trying to intentionally damage your hands. So if you feel like the skin is coming off, if you feel something tweak, stop. We'll do something else. And little by little, you know, your light punches will become harder and harder until eventually you're throwing as hard as you can just your bare fist.
That doesn't hurt you?
No.
I talked to MMA fighters yesterday. I was at an MMA show. And I asked them about fighting in foreign gloves, and they go, Elie, sometimes when we land the punch, it hurts us just as much as it hurt the guy we landed on. Because no padding. But if they did a lot of this, they would do better, right? This would strain their knuckles in their hands, because they don't do it.
I would imagine that they also do this type of stuff.
When I first started covering this bag, it was in one shape. What happened? It got beat up? That's a good sign, right?
Exactly, yeah.
Where do you buy this? It's not every gym has this. Very few gyms have it. I've seen it more in overseas gyms.
Most of the boxing catalogs will have something like this.
But I rarely gyms have. Seen it in Europe. Seen it in the Middle East. I haven't seen it in the U.S. too much.
Guess you got to come to Outlaws then. You experience the wall target.
How would you use the wall target, Brandon? What do you do here? Do you have like numbers? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5?
Well, I have a number system for the punches. We do a lot of that the fist conditioning that I talked about.
So give us a workout of a fist workout with this. So you tell your fighter, come here and I want you to do what?
Again, I want them to progressively condition their hands where they could confidently and safely throw the same punches they would throw with like a 16-ounce glove and hand wraps on with nothing.
So
right? I want to get them to the point where, you know, the glove is not what's protecting their hands. Their hands are what protects
their
hands.
So that will prevent injuries, breaking, fractures?
It'll help prevent it. You know, nothing I can do will ever like completely rid boxing of
for
that.
For people watching, I want to explain to them. If they had this at home, which I think maybe one day someone will see this in a gym, you take 3 minutes and all you can do is throw straight punches, or do you throw hooks?
Hooks, everything. Yeah, whatever.
You just say throw punches until you're comfortable and it doesn't hurt.
To a certain level of fighter, yes.
Do you like that?
Oh, yeah.
You use it a lot?
Elie, punch.